from, they just kidding. All these niggas screaming, not familiar, not familiar. How you a killer with some feelings? Catch him on a block, hit a nigga in his.
What's the word? It's your boy Mac, aka Joe the Mac.
It's your boy Juice Osama.
It's your boy Clutch, man. This is Love of Loyalty, the podcast, man. What they do?
We got a special guest on with us today. We'll introduce himself.
Man, Kevo the Great, baby. Know what it is.
Let's get it. First question we ask everybody, love or loyalty?
Love.
Well, you said you were down there on the first special.
I was just going to say, it was the first person to say love. The reason I say love, man, because me and you talk, Juice, mm-hmm. and I say loyalty all day. I was on that loyalty shit the whole time, but you gotta really look into what love is, bro. Like, nigga, like the love a person got for their baby. Let's use that for example. A woman got for her daughter or her son, newborn, like the love, nigga, that's love. Like, nobody never experienced real love with the exception of your mama. Or your grandma, or somebody that, you know what I'm saying? Yeah,
that's the only.
I want love.
That's the only, like, real. To me, the only real type of love. You would never get that nowhere else.
But I'm saying, if that's what love is, nigga, that's what I want. And I ain't gonna. I mean, I might not find it, but I'd rather have love than loyalty, because loyalty is condition based to me. You know what I'm saying?
What you mean?
You gotta do something to get loyalty. You gotta do something to get loyalty, nigga. It ain't just given to you. Loyalty ain't just no. Ain't given to you. Loyalty is based off of what you can do or what you did or proving yourself, bro. Love is love, nigga. Love is everything. You know what I'm saying? Like, you ain't got to do shit to get love. And I'm talking about that love that a mama got for her child. Nigga, that's love. So we defining love. Nigga, that's what love is. Nobody ever got that with the exception from your parents. But love is love. Like, that's what I want.
So do you think you can find that type of love out here in the streets?
Yeah, bro. No, not in the streets. What are you doing?
You say you choose love over loyalty. Like, so if your homie in the situation
was... that's in life in general.
Yeah, bro. But we just talking about relationships. Niggas be tied in like that, bro. Like, I got some partners that really, I feel like, not that type of love, but it's enough. You know what I'm saying? And fuck the loyalty part, because nigga could get $1 million right now and do whatever to you. Like, or get something done to you. Like, so we ain't talking about loyalty, man. I don't want that.
But to me, like, so, like, the same way you just said about love, real loyalty, money ain't changing that.
Yeah, but real loyalty, what makes you loyal to a person?
You gotta love them.
I feel like it's loyalty to me, like, but to me, I feel like it's a trait.
And it's a trait? No, it's not a trait, bro. Because, like we all say, nigga, we all be in relationships and shit. And I'm just speaking in general. Mm-hmm. Like, relationships, baby, nigga, the nigga gonna do what he gonna do. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? So it's condition-based to me. You know what I'm saying? I might not be right, but it's condition-based to me because, nigga, you be out here fuck a bitch and, you know, I can curse him.
Yeah.
I know people be cursing with shit, you know how I go. But, you know what I'm saying? Like, nigga, be out here fucking on hoes and shit and doing what they do, but it's still the fact that, nigga, you can still love a motherfucker, but it ain't that love. Or you can say you love a motherfucker.
Loyalty might be a choice.
Loyalty is condition-based choice, bro. It's an emotion.
You can say the same thing with love.
You can't, bro.
Like, my question I was going to ask you was, you said pure love is from the way a parent love their child. It's pure love.
No, so that's, I'm just saying, that's the standard for love.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Not all love going to be that.
That's true. So my question is, if a nigga say he love you, you got a nigga that's loyal to you. Mm-hmm. And the nigga say he love you, he ain't gonna never do shit to you. Mm-hmm. But he get put in that position where he got to give you up, or he gonna, or they gonna kill him. Mm-hmm. You think the nigga that love you gonna be like, nah, I ain't giving
the
up
nigga
my nigga.
The nigga that love you, and what I'm talking him, about
or
real
you think
love.
The nigga that's loyal to you, that's gonna be like, nah, I ain't giving up my nigga.
What makes him loyal to you?
Time shows.
I'm gonna get whatever I want to Rex for family, but I should once. Two-tone color and choke, yeah. Feeling like Giannis, I get bucks. We really running it up. Bitch, don't spill what's in my cup, yeah. It's going down, going down, yeah. Look at you, my bedroom. Need that shit right now. It's going down, going down. I'll make you feel special. Let me show you how, yeah, yeah.
That shit shows loyalty. I ain't gonna lie, that means it's a choice. See, look, my thing, that's why I wanted Keith on the show. I ain't gonna lie, for me, him had these conversations before. Mm-hmm. Once we just sitting around the football field and straight just talking, and we had these talks, and I'm like, man, what the fuck. And I don't look at it like, I look at certain things different, but this nigga got a standard, the same mindset I got, but like I say, he just got, like I said, a brighter understanding for a lot of different things. That's why, like I said, usually we ask somebody this question, everybody said the same thing, loyalty, loyalty. And my thing, like, shit, I still would say loyalty, just because, like I said, my background, like, shit, I've been in a situation where a nigga legit can love you. Mm-hmm. But like I said, a nigga can love you too much where he kill you.
But what's love? But that's not love, bro. You gotta understand, bro, like, niggas can say we love and we could fake half-ass show it. You know what I'm saying? But nigga, what's real love, bro? Your mama ain't gonna do nothing to you, bro.
Snap shit. Like, what about the women that love people to love their man so much they kill him if they don't want the nigga?
Because there's other emotions involved with that, bro. It's other emotions involved in just love, bro. Love a tricky ass emotion, bro. Because you can love a motherfucker.
Like, love is a drug.
That's what I'm saying. So you can love a motherfucker and straight hate a motherfucker at the same time, because it's like, nigga, love is control, bro. Like, love a lot of shit, bro. We can go deep into this, but you know what I'm saying? Because I sit at home and study and I think a lot, you know what I'm saying? But nigga, the same, it's like the God and the devil, nigga, it's close. It's either or, nigga, like love and hate, the same thing. Boom, it's a choice at that point. You know what I'm saying? Nigga, I can love you enough to say, nigga, I'm done. I can't fuck with you. But loyalty gonna force me on you, nigga. I'm loyal to you until something happens. You know what I'm saying? Now with the love, out of love, nigga, you ain't finna get none of that bullshit. You ain't gonna get nothing that you gonna get with loyalty. When you love a motherfucker, you ain't gonna have that choice to, oh, I could do this to a motherfucker. Nah, nigga, love is pure love, nigga. I'ma handle that. If I love you, I'ma handle that. It ain't gonna get to you.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like, that's love to me. You know what I'm saying? But loyalty, nigga, it's a choice. Like, I don't know. That shit might not be worth that. Yeah, I can be loyal tomorrow and the day.
I feel like it has an expiration date.
Yeah, baby.
I feel like it do. They feel like it don't.
Shit. Loyalty, motherfucker, bro. It's tricky because, nigga, we just throw words around as black people. As niggas, like, we just throw words around. Oh, that's my dog. I'm loyal, bro. Come on, man. You niggas don't even know what love is for real. Like, ain't nobody you know what I'm saying? Like, man, come on. We throw words around. I'm a real nigga. All this shit. What's all that goofy shit, bro? Because, nigga, we all broke. And, nigga, once a nigga get a chance to get some money, it cross any one of y'all. You know what I'm saying? Like, so, nigga, stop throwing these words around. But I'm saying to accept something, like, nigga, I accept love over loyalty. And I'm talking about real love. Because when I be looking, niggas don't really get deep into it. They just loyalty. Why? Oh, nigga, because I want my, all that shit. But I'm saying, nigga, real love, that's what I want. Yeah.
Like what I said before, like the love you got for your kids. Yeah. Like I said, real love is something that, like I said, it's not taught. Everybody over here got kids. You never have to tell your kids what love is.
Yeah.
My 4-year-old, I can be like, I love you. You know what it means. I love you back. I ain't never have to.
But it's an action too with it. It's an action with it. You know what I'm saying? The way you treat a motherfucker. But still, it's real love. Like, and we could fake, like, I mean, we probably never get it.
Now we got a definition of love.
Yeah.
That's what, like, they just know.
It's a feeling. It's something that wasn't talked to them. They know it's just a real organic feeling. That's what it is.
Yeah.
Well, I said, that's real love.
You're not going to get that outside this house.
You're not going to get
outside of that. Now you know the difference. And it's explained good with kids. Like, they know they ain't getting this outside the crib.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Motherfucker, go have fun. But they know where the crib at. And, nigga, that's love. You know what I'm saying? I don't have another choice, nigga. I don't have another choice to not love you. You know what I'm saying?
Like,
so with that type of mindset, like I say, knowing the real definition of love is really that.
Mm-hmm.
Like I asked y'all before, benefits of, like, marriage.
Mm-hmm.
Why is that even a goal if you're never going to, you can stay with your wife, I love you, but you're never going to get that real life feeling. You're never going to get that.
You think they don't?
I know that.
I think you will never get that.
You'll never get it.
You will never get that.
And marriage is basically, marriage is loyalty. That's the loyalty thing. Like, nigga, marriage is not love. Marriage is loyalty. How much a nigga can be loyal to their wife. It ain't the other way around, bro. We can fake like females got it, like niggas do. It's solely based on how loyal you can be to your wife. That's basically what marriage is. I'm going to keep it real. And, Mac, we can talk about it. You know what I'm saying? Whatever. You know what I'm saying? However you want to talk about it, we can talk about it. But I'm telling you what it is, bro. Like, and we can discuss it. You know what I'm saying? Because I know, you know.
I disagree.
I'm with you. I knew it.
You say that you can't get that love in marriage that you get from your parents. You won't get that love. You won't get that love nowhere else in the world. But in marriage, you can get close to that love.
Fuck
them. Mac, lose your job and lose your hustle, nigga, and sit on that couch for a month and see what happens.
Listen. I haven't worked in 2 to 3 months.
Mm-hmm.
Bills paid up because when I work hard, I work hard.
You did.
Bills paid up. When I work hard, I work hard. I've been literally chilling at the crib, playing the game. I don't give a fuck about work right now. I'm choosing not to work. And I have not heard not one complaint from her about it.
Your bills paid up?
Bills paid up.
Them bills get behind.
I haven't heard one complaint from her.
I'm saying, man, and you know, you family, so.
Right.
Nigga, it is what it is. Let them bills get behind and let's just start getting bad for her. You know what I'm saying? And not saying that I don't know your situation like that, but nigga, it's all good now because it's all good. But let shit start fucking up and then she can't do what she want to do. And I'm solely not talking about your situation, bro. I'm talking about in general. It's going to fall on you.
And when shit do get ugly and shit do go south, that's when you really depend on your love. Because if you love me, then you finna trust me to go hurt and get shit back on the right road.
But why are we waiting to get it on the road? And I'm saying that that's loyalty because it ain't love. It's loyalty. It's basically strictly trusting in me.
When the shit get that down and dirty, they always got their mama in their back pocket that they can shake. So it ain't about loyalty at that point. Because they can just get up, all right, I'm going to my mama's house.
You just touch about loyalty, though.
That's not loyalty to that point right there. That's going off of love.
Folks ain't waiting that long, bro. I'm figuring something out right now. While you sitting on the couch playing that game, I'm gonna figure something out, bro.
That's a thousand.
You say 3 months, motherfuckers figuring it out, bro.
That's worth a thousand.
Man, look. All it takes is one time.
Man, listen.
All it takes is one time,
that,
baby.
When you got that real love.
So, Mac, you saying you got that?
Yeah, I do.
I'm with you, bro. I'm happy for you, my nigga. I ain't never seen it.
I ain't never had it.
I'm talking about my grandma and granddaddy. When I look back on it, bro. It was flaws in that shit, but
it's gonna be flaws in everything.
And I legit tell people that shit because I know girls I fuck when they be like, "Well, my granny been married, my granddaddy for 30-40 years." I'm like, "Yeah, but once again, wait till this fucked up disabled you
wait till
the
nigga
somebody
die and all this whole
show come up."
This lady been with this man for 30-40 years and don't know about a second family.
She probably do.
You think she gonna go that long being that naive?
Well, it's different now. We ain't on social media.
It's social media that plays a big part of it.
Cause she would have been bounced. Come on, bro. Like, most mothers don't really felt like they really didn't have a choice. This nigga paying all the bills. That's brainwashed.
I know some niggas that. Right now, Joe, goddamn you, they don't play the social media, and the girl don't play the social media. Nigga got three lives right now.
Man,
nigga living three whole lives. Goddamn, one don't know about the next.
And the nigga happy.
I know for sure the nigga living three lives.
And the nigga happy, I guarantee you. Because the mother getting a meal, some good heads, and some other shit on the oven, you know?
And doing
or some peace, you know what I'm saying?
I know back in the day, that shit probably was a little, especially you way across town.
No cell phones, no way to track me, man. I'm outside.
It's crazy that we're talking about this shit today. Saturday, it was at me, you, and Lowe's. Just at Lowe's, I was talking about this shit. I'm like, okay, man, because I don't know how we got on the topic. But, you know, we had an episode talking about, you know, niggas knowing their worth and happiness and all that type of shit. I'm talking to these niggas about certain shit like this. We having a whole conversation. And I'm just thinking about what the fuck we're talking about right now, where you just said, okay, merge, in your situation, it works.
Yeah, it works.
I ain't gonna lie, that's... I'm gonna say you part of that 1%.
Your wife watching this, Mac, ain't she?
She watched every episode. That's
I'm
not
feeling
what
I'm on
saying.
You, baby. I'm here with you.
That's not what I'm saying. I'm not saying that because I don't care about that. Because listen, it's been plenty of years where I took a year off because I didn't want to go to work for nobody. I didn't want to do shit, so I took a year off.
But
and I
was that trying to hurt, bro.
But
love went work ways, and I'm saying, man, we talking about men, bro.
There's been plenty of times where. Like, when we just had our baby, she literally set the whole year off because I told her she could. She didn't have to go with Mac. She set the whole year off.
Listen to me. This is the real world, bro. This is 2022. One mistake, niggas, everybody fuck. Man. You know what I'm saying? So why are we taking shit that we don't have to take off? And I'm just speaking, bro, I'm speaking to myself for real. Why are we waiting so, I could do this. I could chill for 3 months. And I'm not speaking on your situation. I'm just saying, I could chill for 3 months. Now, why are we ain't trying to get 3 months ahead? You know what I'm saying? Like, if I love you, I'm going to rock hard for you. Nigga, fuck taking 3 months off. I'm going to do this for 3 months, and then I'm going to double up next month. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm saying as black people, we think, oh, we cool, the bills paid, all this shit. But what about, nigga, the extra shit that we can't be doing while we just chilling? You know what I'm saying? And I'm solely speaking to myself because I take time off, too, and be like, damn, I could have ran it up a little bit.
Because black people want them bills paid, they're comfortable.
Content.
They content and they trick off that money for bullshit.
Yeah,
it's like, well, I don't got these bills, I can use this money on this.
Yeah.
And it's fucked up. I feel like it's fucked
up. But see, I took my time off because I'm, you know what the union construction might be. You do all the racist motherfucker like that. So you need time off for your mental self. Like, I was finna snap on a white boy at work. Like, I'm literally on my IG story posting every day me and this dude get into it because he stages on some racist shit. Hey, boy, didn't I tell you? Man, who the fuck you calling? Boy, bro. Stop calling me boy. Like, no bullshit, bro. Man,
I used to be like
and
that.
And do not even in my company, though. So,
in order for me to throw you off your square, bro, like, I used to be like that snappy, nigga. Like, I don't fuck about none of this shit, nigga. I'll turn this motherfucker. But what that's gonna get you, bro, the world is racist, my nigga.
The world racist.
Like, and I'm talking about both ways.
I took time off for myself.
Yeah, y'all saying
racist.
How
y'all feel about that Kyrie shit?
I'm rocking with Kyrie, bro.
I feel like
it's the fact that, bro, nigga, Kyrie is a nigga. First off, you can't change, bro. You can't be white. You can't be nothing else. White people can fuck with niggas, and then they can change back to they who they want to be. You got a choice as a white person, man. And I no disrespect, because some of my best friends are white, bro. My grandma white. Shit. You know what I'm saying? So, you got a choice, but niggas don't got a choice. We niggas forever. That's all we is. That's all we gonna ever be. Jewish, you niggas don't really know what Jewish people is. We think they white. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? So, and it's just saying white niggas like where we came from, bro. Now, I don't get into the, my mom and my grandma and them picked cotton. I don't get into that, bro, because, I mean, it's history, but it's not direct. Nigga, all right, we went through some shit. Let's figure this shit out now. I don't get into all that, you know what I'm saying? But it's still the fact that niggas get caught too far back, bro, and we can't progress. Kyrie a fucking millionaire, bro. Like, and we get caught up in that. That's being.
I feel like what they doing with him, though, like you said, that's the problem. Because mother say our problem is when it comes out to our celebrities and shit, we low key idolize them.
Mm-hmm.
So that's why when shit like this is done to them niggas, where we get so in our feelings about it, where. We hurt like they doing it to us.
I ain't gonna lie, nigga. LeBron, my dog, anybody will tell you, nigga, and he hurt me, bro. That hurt me, nigga. I'm talking about straight hurt me, nigga. I'm like, damn, come on, bro, please. Like, don't let me, man, this nigga straight hurt my feelings, bro. And I was rocking with LeBron.
He could have just no comment.
I said nothing,
no comment. You don't have to.
I ain't gonna lie, though.
No comment, don't say nothing either way.
That's the same thing as me saying what he said. You gotta think of, like, niggas legit talk so much shit about Michael Jordan, because back then, where all the race shit happened, he didn't say nothing.
Yeah.
They're like, well, nigga, you never stood up for niggas.
But I'm gonna say this, bro. That's a prime example of the motherfucking controlling your back, bro. These niggas are being controlled, bro. You just think niggas is way, and I ain't gonna say way better than Bron, but niggas can make it. Niggas could have made it, but it's still the fact that so much shit you gotta go through to make. They selective on who they let make it, bro. He the face of the world. Damn near one of the faces of the world, bro. I'm talking about LeBron.
Yeah.
And you straight, you do this, bro, it's gotta be something else, bro. It's gotta be something. Motherfucker made you do that.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I feel like that. But damn, bro, Bron. If you look into it, that billionaire shit, that billionaire back, they say this. You taking that billionaire back. They said it. He just dropped a little snippet in the quote. He talking shit about it. He saying some real shit. I ain't gonna lie, I'm a nigga, don't really like LeBron. It ain't really like that shit, but man, look, these people legit. Hey, like I say, it's a control thing.
Yeah, baby.
That's why I said they legit doing them, trying to hang Kyrie in front of the world. They legit trying to hang this man in front of all the niggas.
Yeah, everything.
This is y'all best nigga right here.
Y'all show not, you this better nigga. Not do it because you broke.
Let me show y'all. You broke. This nigga millionaire. Like, you can do this to him.
Facts.
Now we can do to him. Let's see what you broke niggas can do.
Everything he's saying be facts, though. That's the crazy part. Everything he's saying is straight facts. You can look it up and it be facts, though. That's what's crazy.
See,
and
we still just came out.
Be killing each other. That shit crazy.
Shit, man, the shit that came out, like, nigga, the white people, like dude was saying, white people, you can bash white people and do all that, nigga. When you talking about them Jewish people, bro, like, it's an issue.
Yeah, they running the world.
You know what I'm saying? I went into it a little bit, you know what I'm saying, as far as, nigga, they know, they do the medicine. Like, they mastered the medicine. Like, the doctor and all that shit. Like, they, man, I've been deep, trying to get deep into it. But I stay up, you know what I'm saying? I stay up off of that shit because it ain't even in my lane, bro. I don't have a voice for the world, bro. I'm still trying to figure my shit out and my people around me, you know what I'm saying?
Well, I think even with what you just said, like you said, you've been reading up on it, just getting the knowledge on it. Shit, you just saying it right here. Let's just say, nigga, if we only get 30 viewers, out of 30 niggas, 15 listen to what you just said, and they go back and read up on it. Now, them niggas got the information. That's another 15 with their information. It can keep going on, where mm-hmm. more niggas getting knowledge. That's the thing. Like, reality, bro. We don't know look, shit.
You think don't know how big your voice really is, for real.
Yeah, but I try to. Man, this the biggest, our biggest downfall, bro. Like, y'all niggas doing this, bro. Like, I tell y'all all this, nigga, I'ma share y'all shit, nigga. I'ma support whatever, bro. But how many niggas doing that you really know, bro? It shouldn't be. Nigga, we got 10,000 people in our flag league, and I'm talking about connections. Mm-hmm. As far as, nigga, your family, they family, nigga, your sisters, they boyfriends, they boyfriend. Like, man, this shit can blow up, bro. But we so fucking caught up in us leading the race that we don't even... We can't even help our people, bro.
I'm in a bucket shit.
You know what I'm saying, nigga? We so... I'm better than y'all. You know what I'm saying? Oh, I'm going to start my podcast. Man, they got their shit going, bro. They got their building. You know what I'm saying? They got their equipment, bro. Support these brothers, man. Like, we family, bro. Like, nigga, it's too many people in our flag league alone. And I know y'all know people outside of that. But in our flag league alone, bro. Like, come on, man. Like, what we doing,
Jay-Z,
bro?
I seen Jay-Z say something about the whole time we've been looking at the crab in the bucket thing the wrong way. Like, we should have been looking at it. What if it was we stack each other, climb up mm-hmm. on each other and climb out, and the one crab bring everybody out the bucket, but we've been brainwashed to think, you know what I'm saying, everybody pulling each other down and shit.
That, once again, even with shit like that, because this conversation gonna go somewhere else. So, you know, even with shit like that, y'all gotta understand that's a design thing, though.
Yeah, I understand.
Even with the NBA, they tell kids as a little kid, when you was in elementary school, what's your goal? I want to be an NBA player. What they say, where the percentage that happens is they tell you, like, okay, you can have all the talent. You can have the talent, he can have the talent. But they're going to choose between y'all. They taking this nigga because of something. Because once again, politics, he got something else.
It's always politics. It's always control.
You got to think about rappers. Nigga, rappers legit. We know 1,000 terrible rappers that's millionaires. They don't make it because they can rap. They make it because they influence. That's legit what they go off of, the way they can influence niggas.
That politics shit falling everything. Let's think about sports. The kid from the city, from the state, you know what I'm saying? Like, let's say me and you both on a scholarship to any college, right? Mm-hmm. And you from that state, but I'm not. You get a look before me, you know what I'm saying? Just because you from there. It's all here. All that politics behind everything, baby. Politics behind everything.
Made it to the league. Back when I was in high school, bro, they had a stereotype on St. Louis niggas. Like, man, y'all niggas ain't built for college. Like, y'all just be doing some goofy shit. We ain't messing with y'all. You pick one out of 90. You know what I'm saying? With the exception of some of them out in the county schools. But niggas wasn't really going to college for real. Like,
and it's so fucked up. But low key, I ain't gonna say it's true. But like, and you just break it down in history wise. I ain't gonna say basketball. We're gonna just say football. Think of every NFL player that came from St. Louis.
Yeah.
I ain't gonna lie, I'm a normie nigga, so we all know about Lawrence.
Yeah.
Lawrence was a problem. Christian Moore. Christian Arden.
Christian was
a problem. You got a couple guys that still in the league doing their thing. Marcus Golden. Zeke, all them.
Yeah.
But like you talking about the city kids, we wanna keep it hunting. Shit, they do get into some dumb ass trouble. Like, when Lawrence got in that bullshit, shit don't make sense.
But you still, man, you gotta, bro. 9 times out of 10, if you a nigga from the Lou, bro, you really in a fucked up situation anyway, bro. And that shit
don't come back.
So it ain't gonna really just, you really not gonna change, bro. You could take a nigga from the Lou and put him anywhere, and he gonna make it. Because niggas is designed for, we been through the worst of the worst, bro. You can't really go nowhere in St. Louis that ain't dangerous except Chesterfield, motherfucking out in Olivet, out there where they control. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? But for real, honestly, bro, they niggas talk about North County. Nigga, North County been on that. Like, man, come on, man. Come on, dog. It ain't safe. But, you know what I'm saying? Where do niggas that we know really come from? You know what I'm saying? The Normandies, the Vachons, even the Parkway Centers. My boy went to DJ. Daryl Jackson went to Webster Groves. And that nigga stayed on Grand. Oh, man. One of the top quarterbacks coming out when I came out, bro. Like, shit, nigga went to Mizzou. Got into some trouble or whatever. But, man, nigga was the top quarterback, bro. He stayed on Grand, bro. They desegged him out to Webster Groves. And won the championship. State championship. They put us in a fucked up situation, and we don't never get out because, and I'm gonna say this, I'm gonna speak on this too. We don't get out that situation because we feel sorry for ourselves, bro.
What you mean?
some niggas take it like feeling sorry for yourself, bro. Like, niggas always got that excuse. You know what I'm saying? Oh man, it's rough for us, bro. Like, let's get it. Like, no, it's rough for you, bro, because you ain't leaning on your brother, and your brother ain't leaning on you. That's why it's rough for us. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Man, I'm just saying, if nigga Barlow's made $60,000 a year, you know what I'm saying? Nigga, what can we do with $60,000 all together? You know what I'm saying? Let's do something. Let's get a convenience store. Let's do something, bro. Like, and we put it together, and whatever we make, bro, and then branch off and do something else. Or get into these houses, bro. But niggas wanna, I ain't fuck with them nigga. Oh, I only got 60. We all got 60. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying, nigga? Let's take 20 apiece. Yeah, put 80 together.
I ain't gonna lie. Like I told y'all before, like, man, once again, no, niggas scared to take the risk, but low-key, that shit is scary.
It ain't scared to take the risk, bro. It's scared to see you win.
That's what it is.
Nigga scared to see you win.
That's what it is.
This nigga the shit with nothing. Nigga, I don't want to see this nigga with nothing.
Niggas don't know what help means.
I'm telling you,
like,
bro.
Niggas don't know what help really means. Like, if I did something for you, like, for instance, niggas be saying Nelly don't never do nothing for the city, but the nigga opened up a school. You know what I'm saying? That's doing something for the opening up a school for the, you know what I'm saying?
School shit. You put a spotlight on the
school. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. That's helping, but they say the nigga never helped the city. You know what I'm saying?
Chicago, yes. Like the whole old block having niggas on fuck with you, kid. Yeah. Because a lot of niggas want you legit to legit. Okay, here, I'm going to carry you to this motherfucker. Nah, nigga, my name big, the hood big, y'all got the name, people come over here and do something.
We don't know how to appreciate help. That's what it is. Man, you know what I'm saying? Appreciate help and help the next.
We black people stuff, man. We want financial help, bro. When you say help, I look at help as, nigga, I got a motherfucker I can talk to. That can call me at 3 o'clock in the morning when I'm going through something, nigga. That's help to me, like, and me returning that favor. But these niggas won't. Man, that nigga ain't never did nothing for me. What you want, $100? Like, what you want?
Me to money is do everything. It for you.
I tell you, I just told a girl this shit the other day. Money is only important to broke people. I ain't gonna lie to you. Like, look, millionaires ain't legit tripping off of whatever this money. Like, they worry about the connection. Yeah. I tell people this shit all the time. Let's say I'm fucking with a girl. Okay. I probably don't know how to tow a car or do all this shit.
But you know,
I got a plug. I can call her. Look, instead of this nigga charging you $200. Just off of me, he gonna charge you $40.
Mm-hmm.
All right, boo. That's a plus for me. Mm-hmm. There's some people that don't want. They're like, nah, fuck that, nigga. Pay him the $40 plus. Come over and do this. Mm-hmm. Like, okay, I can do that. But once again, it's still my plug.
Right.
I'm still looking out. Like I said, we got, man. Look, I don't like. We supposed to did a whole episode about money versus connections. Cause a lot of niggas don't understand the fucking difference between those two.
Man, people minds is just stuck on, man, social media.
Up materialistic shit.
And I was looking on Facebook, bro. I was at my crib working on my house or whatever. I got a few houses and shit, so I'm working on one of them today. And I'm just scrolling through Facebook because the shit is fucking controlling, bro. I'm talking about, nigga, I have my phone a lot, nigga. And then I just scroll through Facebook. I'll be bored. Well, I can say bored, nigga, but I'm working. That motherfucker is controlling everybody. The phone is, and I'm saying, bro, I'm scrolling through.
It's even got our kids now.
Little chick I see online, the bitch so bad, bro. And all she doing is steady spinning around. I'm like, I got tired of looking at her. I'm like, this bitch cool. This bitch is bad, but what is she doing?
Man.
Man, I'm talking about the bitch so raw, nigga. Hey, man.
It's funny you see that.
She spent around like 12 times. Hey, like,
look, I ain't gonna say who the girl is, but funny you said this shit. A couple weeks ago, look, we all doing a little night job together.
Yeah.
We in a car. We counting niggas' likes and shit like that. He's like, this bitch picture, this me town, look, I ain't gonna laugh. This nigga turning on me like, nah, Juice, you talking shit. And you like, this bitch more than my show. Like,
yeah, you heard me?
Get to the point, I see this bitch post shit now. I'm gonna go see if this nigga like
that. Yeah, you heard me?
I see
this
like that. I like that.
Hell
yeah.
I'm
like,
but let a motherfucker just put some normal up there. Hey, y'all, support my biz. You got 3 likes. You go on this motherfucker, she spent around. She got 1,500. You know what I'm saying? And man, motherfuckers think. I don't know, bro. I don't know what they do with the money on Facebook or how it go, bro. But motherfuckers be really on there showing their ass, bro.
Man.
Because like I say, social media gave people a platform to reinvent themselves.
Yeah.
Like you said, okay, let's just talk about the flag league. You can go out there and watch a game. You can sit out there all day, watch a game, watch niggas play. Lead that motherfucker. The team that just lost. You can see a nigga like, yeah, we lost, but shit, I had 12 sacks.
Cornball.
And you legit watched this whole game. Knowing this nigga capped the fuck out of lane, you like, damn.
Man, 90% of these flag niggas is straight cornballs, bro.
Trash.
They get out there and try to be somebody else, bro.
Like, it's crazy because, like,
man, you can see it. You can see a lane. You can feel it, bro. Like, you know,
energy.
You can feel a lane of when you feel around like a lane. You know what I'm saying?
I feel like they're asking for approval from another flag, nigga.
Man, I'll be out for
proof of love.
And that's what I mean by lame. Like that. Yeah, like I ain't, you know what I'm saying? You like are whoever you are. You know what I'm saying? Exactly. But I'm saying like when you looking for something from another, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Like you need that.
You're not a man.
That's when you're lame. Like that's the lame I'm talking about.
We just went live. What I tell you, I say, man, look, we's on the flag page going live. I told niggas, I say, bro, I know who I am in real life.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
I'm okay. I'm comfortable with who I am in real life, not on this flat. Like, I'm talking about a nigga outside in this city.
Yeah,
I'm good wherever the fuck I go. Just cause once again, it ain't about nothing. No, my energy. I ain't gonna lie. I'm a nigga. I'm cool. Like nigga, man, just fuck. I'm legit a man.
Yeah,
a lot of people don't understand that. Like, and I feel like for real, that's a lot of problems that we had. Shit, that's one of the biggest problems we have in St. Louis. Everybody trying to put on this fake image of everything else. Not doing that, being real is legit being yourself.
Man, being real is just an energy, bro. Like, nigga, ain't no way I'm mad at you because of what somebody said. Ain't no way I'm mad at you because, nigga, we done had a flag game. We done had some words, bro. That's a hobby to me, bro. Man, I'm real. I'm going to give everybody a chance to be cool. And if not, then I don't got to deal with you. I ain't beefing with you, nigga. I ain't going to deal with you. I don't have to. I'll get out the way. That's why I don't come out there a lot, because it's just like,
you don't bring that energy out. You know,
bringing that goofy shit. And I know me. You know what I'm saying? I was going through a little moment. Me and you talk, nigga. I was going through a little moment where I was just snapping. Nigga, I was crashing out. Like, I'm like, hold on, nigga. This ain't you. I mean, fuck him. I ain't even coming around nobody. You know what I'm saying? Because I'm trying to get myself together.
Facts.
Man. You know what I'm saying? Because this not me. This ain't the energy I bring.
And that's I tell people all the time. Motherfucker, ask me why I don't go out, why I don't do shit. I'm like, man, I'm not scared of shit. I don't guard you out the strength of I know what I would do. So my thing is like, I'm not about to even put myself around no goofy niggas, no goofy energy when we know.
Because niggas in the club get so tough. Come on, bro. Man. You just stepped on my shoe. What you trying to do all that for?
Bro.
You in the wrong nigga. Like, you know what I'm saying?
I was 10.
I'm saying, like, it's going to go there, but I'm saying, like, bro, just don't avoid
it.
I mean, I'll go there, but I don't want to. And I'm so grown, bro, I won't even put myself in a position. I have to go there. Nigga, I don't go out. I don't drink. I smoke at the crib. Nigga, I'm cool. I'm cool in my little bubble. Mm-hmm. And, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, nigga, we've been talking about this. Man, you have to come on. You know what I'm saying, bro? Let me know when you're ready. It didn't work out the last time. But, nigga, like, nigga, I'm here. Like, and, nigga, I support y'all niggas. I played in the thing with the shirt on. You know what I'm saying? You hear me? I'm rocking with my guys. Nigga gave me a hat. I still got it. You know what I'm saying? I'm rocking with my guys, bro. Anybody that's doing something that I'm connected to, bro, I'm rocking with them till the wheels fall off,
life, we real life appreciate that, bro.
Oh,
like,
man, for sure.
No fake. Like, this is, we real life. Like, we real life fuck with you, bro. Like, we speak on you, you know what I'm saying, outside of this podcast shit. Like, you know, this is real life. Like, fuck,
solid niggas that I'm talking about, I met on some hooping shit. Straight like, oh, you talking about Key, you said something like that. Like, bro, nah, Brody a real ass nigga. Like, hey. I'm like, man, straight crazy. We had that talk. I said, man, nah, nigga ain't lying. Like, that nigga straight, I'm talking like every time I had a conversation, like, it ain't me and Biggs, it's just me and you. James.
We
just sitting here, I'm talking about talking for hours, all shit going on around
me.
Man, we in this motherfucker talking about everything. From relationships
James solid
to
dude,
everything. That's my dog.
James solid, man. I like the nigga because he a humble dude. And he don't really have to. Yeah, I know. That's
that don't mean shit.
See, but I don't want to say it. You know how I go.
See, look.
I hope
the females got a problem with
everything. Man, everybody do.
But now we know what it is. Once again, like I told that last, that's the crown over my motherfucking head where I sit.
Shit, energy, bro. It's the energy, bro. I ain't never been no bad Aries, bro. And a motherfucker can say what they want to say, but, nigga, you know, it's 9 times out of 10, it's a female dog and a nigga Aries. Mm-hmm. But, you know, how that go. Hey, dog.
Let me ask y'all a question. So, once again, like I say, y'all, everybody over here being in a relationship, got shit going on, whatever. Is it important for your relationship if your partner is, I guess, okay with your friends? Is that something important to a relationship? So, like, let's say, okay, you hang out with your partners 50% of the time. Mm-hmm. I mean, the other 50% you with your gear. Mm-hmm. Is that a must that both sides be okay with each other? Or do you just, like, fuck it, you really don't care how she feel about your friends?
Yeah, I'm going to speak on it.
You will care.
So, you know what I'm saying? Like, is this important?
You will care. I feel like it's important for them to get along, or at least try to get along for your sake. Because, like, if some shit happened to you and you with your friends, they don't like each other.
They don't have to mix. Like, you got I got partners, you know what I'm saying, that I hang with, and then I hang with this group of niggas, you know what I'm saying? But they don't never have to meet.
You talking about your girl and your partners, not just your partners. That's the same.
It's a relationship. It's
not,
man.
Because if your girl don't like this nigga, every time you go with that nigga, she gonna have an attitude. She's gonna start an argument for you.
But listen, Matt, this is the real world, bro. Everybody don't
want to
get married. Life is my life, bro.
You don't have to meet every bitch.
Can't not be with my niggas. Oh, I can't. My girl is my girl. That's my family. That's home. Bro, when I'm out here, nigga, I'm enjoying myself. What makes me happy, bro? We tend to get caught up in, we can't do this because she going to be mad. Nigga, you ain't living your life. You living her life.
And we had this talk.
Man, you living her shit.
This nigga who told Keith, you said, you like, man, look, you to the point where you feel like a female is not happy unless she's the one making you happy.
Yeah.
And you said, if you come home with your big smile on your face, all this shit, what a girl going to say?
Man, why you smiling up for?
Yeah. Who the fuck
that
you
happy? Who the made you happy? Yeah.
Man, that shit crazy.
Yeah, bro.
So now I asked that question just because, like I said, we had a talk the other day, and I'm thinking about the shit like, damn, is there something important to me where if I'm in a relationship, man, my gear, like I said, cool with my partners type shit, or cool with they gear, like basically where everybody can hang out together. Because that's the case. If your girl don't like your partner, I wouldn't even want them around each other. Then you, they go back to knowing your female too, or knowing your partner
have
too.
To be, though. They just have to be.
They have to be.
To trust me. Fuck them. You don't have to deal with them. They don't have to be nothing. You know, I'm kicking it with my partners that you don't like. And then I'll be back. It shouldn't be, I don't approve of him, so you can't hang with him.
So
I'm living your life at that point.
Okay. Y'all go to a wedding type shit. So you know you bring your wife, and these are the dudes that she don't fuck with. But once again, y'all in the same room.
Mm-hmm.
Like, how, like, that type of energy, once again, we understand how energy works. You can feel energy without a motherfucker saying shit. You know, female energy, usually, if they upset, they don't fuck with somebody. But I'm saying that you can feel that energy from across the room. Just flat out, like,
I'm not going to put the energy in the room.
You can't control that energy.
She's not coming.
No, she's not. She, you got to bring her gear to her.
See, Bill, this week.
She's not coming, bro. If you can't, you don't like her. What are you coming for? You ain't doing nothing but bringing negative energy. I know what you're bringing for.
Something like that, you got to explain shit again.
No, but what I'm saying
is, tell her, like, well, she should understand it.
Her respect level for you. I should be able to take you anywhere, and you act like you got some sense if you respect me enough.
Facts.
That's how it's supposed to be.
Facts. That's what I'm saying. So if it ain't that, now, at this point in my life, if it ain't that, I can't really deal with you. I can't deal. I got a choice. I ain't dealing with you because I'm going to do what I do. These my niggas. Like, they my niggas by default. You know what I'm saying? Until further notice, nigga, we been rocking. You not finna stop that because you can be gone today or tomorrow. These going to be my niggas because it's been proven. Over the years, these my niggas. So you don't respect me enough to act like you got some sense around these people that I deal with, then I can't deal with you, baby. Or like you say, you can't come, and then I just fuck on you, and then we figure it out later. Like, you just be one of those. No, real shit. Like, man, no, it's the respect for you that causes the problem. I don't respect you.
You said you think it is important.
I think it low key is. Like I just said, just because of a situation like that. If I'm in the room with my girl, and let's say my partner she don't fuck with or whatever, shit, like I said, I'm big on energy. I can walk into any room and I can feel what type of energy is going on in this room. So my thing, like I just said, you will be able to see a female sitting over there, you can straight tell, like, man, she on when she don't fuck with me. How many times you been around with a motherfucker, you be like, man, buddy straight don't fuck with me at all?
Hell time.
Hella. As a nigga, this the thing. See, usually dudes, I feel like I said, a lot of girls always say that I'm sexist or whatever, but nah, I feel like dudes legit can chump their emotions or chump their feelings up, even though they know the situation, just really off of they partner type of shit. Like, it being a situation where shit, I took blame for all types of shit. Just because, once again, you did the shit for me, you took blame for shit, knowing that I'm really the one fucking up and doing shit. But my thing is, because of my dogs and shit, I'd take this blame before I get my partners in trouble on some goofy ass shit. Mm-hmm. But once again, a lot of shit boils back down to niggas putting their foot down and legit putting their females in their place.
Okay.
Like, so it's a lot of different situations where I feel like, okay, we joke. Anybody know me, I joke and I play around a lot. Is there any time, let's say, okay, Joe, I'm joning. Everybody know I would never join my partners in front of females. Mm-hmm. I don't play around
it's
like
cold,
that.
It's cold.
It's like real, like a cold.
It's supposed to be. These niggas do it.
Like, so when coming to, okay, if I'm joning on you, boo, 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 and just old gear right there. Your girl said something to me, boy, you better be quiet, big ass. Ass, ass. And I'm like, me being a nigga, I'm going to laugh. I'm like, yeah, all right, boo. She said another joke, all right, boo. Say another joke. Check, all right.
Check your bitch.
Now, is that on me for firing her ass up, or is that on this nigga? He should have put it on the plate.
First of all, soon as she said something, he should have been like, hey, look, we got this. We cool. Don't worry about that.
But once again, how many niggas that you really know are standing on that shit and they doing it?
These niggas be crying.
Just speak for them niggas. But I know in a situation like that, my wife won't say shit. She won't say shit.
Okay, so I ain't say shit.
If it's funny, she gonna laugh.
If it's your wife, okay, like, Joe, so you married. If your wife, let's just say your wife don't like Omar, right? And y'all see this whole scenario, you think it's important, right? Mm-hmm. So what do you choose?
Yeah, damn, nigga.
I mean, what?
as that being my wife, I'm choosing her, my nigga.
But at the same time, if she knows, I know that she don't like Omar.
They know I play all day, so look, y'all, I picked up on this shit.
That's why I just said it on purpose.
Damn, boy, look, y'all was supposed to shit.
I'm saying, I didn't just do it on
they
purpose.
They did.
Look, I'm
saying. I saw it in your face, so I did it on purpose.
I'm saying, so what do you do at that point?
What'd you say?
If that's the choice you have to choose, right?
With what?
Between your partner and your girl.
Anybody
that know me, like I say, I joke, I play around, but y'all know me. Y'all know my real attitude and real energy. Now I'm putting my foot down. She's not determining shit.
Right, it should never
like, once again, y'all know this about me, man. Look, I can deal with a little bit of bitching and shit. I can deal with that. Because that ain't shit, but that, it ain't going to last forever.
So it don't matter in a sense, it really don't matter.
Because I'm going to run whatever situation I'm in. I ain't going to lie, I'm running it.
I wouldn't say I'm running it, but let's not say nothing. She won't say nothing.
Hey, I'm cracking that wheel.
I'm with you, bro. To each his own, my nigga. Like, I just look.
So it don't really matter then.
It do matter.
The shit is important, but you just.
Matters, I promise.
I don't want to say. I guess you said running is the wrong word. I'm real good with words and like finessing in a way. Like,
I'm with you.
Mix it like that. Like, I'm one of them type of niggas. Like, I can turn it around, like, try to finesse a little bit where she don't trip off, but if she can legit be in the wrong where I'm doing so much when it comes down to her, she don't notice nobody else in the room.
That's it.
That's how it's supposed to be.
But once again, every nigga ain't like
it that. It ain't like that because the female don't receive it like that. Because 9 times out of 10, the females that's today is looking at, nigga, you doing all this. And they still, like, I can't accommodate you for doing all this, so I'm fucked up anyway. Like, females fuck themselves up because a nigga could be doing all this, bro. And you know, as a female, you know that I can't even pay this nigga back. So now I got to figure out some other shit to distract this nigga from some other shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, females look at good niggas. Like, be like, this nigga pay the bills. This nigga come work every day, bring me money home. I can't repay this nigga. Fuck I'm doing. Like, and he's going to catch on to me not being able to pay him back. Now you tripping off of, is this nigga fucking on a bitch? He doing all this. Is this nigga paying me back for fucking on bitches or doing all that? It's going through their head, bro. I promise you, bro. When a nigga is doing all the shit that they supposed to be doing, and not saying supposed to be because everybody equal, so nigga. But doing what they have to do, bro. Females intimidated by that shit, bro.
Man,
because it's requiring you to do a lot of acts.
So you say they sabotage themselves.
Yeah. You just say that, like I told you, how they say that a lot of people want a nigga to come with their own everything. Yeah. I told y'all that shit sound good. I'm a nigga that's legit. Like I say, single, that doing my thing, got my own everything. Mm-hmm. Man, I'm telling you, bro, that shit caps out.
That's like they saying, they say a man is born a husband, but a wife becomes a wife when you make her a wife.
Nah, that shit. Then that's what niggas fuck up. That saying right there. You can't make no fucking wife, nigga. Wife is gonna be a wife, and not to each his own, cause she might be a wife for you and not for me.
No, I'm saying that's when she decides.
No,
you know what I'm saying?
They gotta come like that already, bro.
You don't make them. I'm not saying.
But niggas go off of what you just said.
But that's what's going on.
Niggas go off of what you just said. I'm gonna build this bitch. I'm gonna make it. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Because the niggas taking bad bitches with good bodies and trying to make them into wives. These hoes for Facebook, they shaking their ass. Man. Like, you know what I'm saying? That's what they, nigga, all these BBLs and shit, that's for social media, bro. Like, and you finna try to marry her because she bad and everybody want her, but then you try to control her when you get her. She was for the streets when you met her. Like, why you think she going out to do all this goofy shit? Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Like, man, she for everybody, bro.
The highest bidder.
And niggas not gonna stop. It ain't gonna stop when you get her. Niggas don't give a fuck about that. That ain't my dog. Like, I heard so many niggas say, oh, that's your partner. That ain't my partner. Damn, bro, you putting me in a fucked up situation. I wouldn't do you like that. Oh, yeah, that ain't my partner. That's your partner. Damn, bro.
Man. There's so many different things. Every time a nigga say something, different situations, then, we deal with a situation. We have people that we know deal with a situation like that, okay, mm-hmm. where it's like, okay, my partner, mm-hmm. right, this is my partner. He got a girl or whatever, boo, 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 they ain't together. Mm-hmm. But once again, my other partner, brother could be slamming this nigga ex. So once again, I'm in the middle by default. Mm-hmm. What do I do in that type of situation?
I'm going to talk to my dog, and if you my dog, you going to listen. Like, bro, look, that ain't the right way to go about it. You know what I'm saying? Like, nigga, man, look.
Bro, talking to your brother legit.
Like I'm talking to... But I'm talking to the nigga that I know. You know what I'm saying? Or that I know that I could talk to. Because I ain't finna tell the nigga that it's his wife getting cracked. This nigga finna start World War III. Nah, we gonna talk to the nigga that's doing the goofy shit. Holler at your people, bro, because that's putting me in a fucked up situation. Now, if you love me and loyal to me, or nigga, we rocking, you gonna holler at that man, bro. Nah, we shouldn't go that route. And 9 times out of 10, the nigga gonna say, that's your partner. That ain't my partner. Right, well, you deal with what come with it then at that point.
So that's yeah.
Man. Man.
That's it so far.
That shit crazy.
Man, I don't play like that, bro. Man. Like I don't play with nobody people, man. Look. It's I'm staying out the way, nigga. I don't know.
That's
cool. I ain't with none of that.
That's how it look. Low key, that's how it's supposed to be for real. I ain't so low key. Hacky, that's how it's supposed to be. Shit just down here. Man, it's pride, but I ain't gonna think it's that. It's to the point where shit. Man, motherfuckers, I don't want to say this because people gonna have something to say, but I really don't give a fuck. Relationships low-key nowadays are pointless.
It is, bro.
The girls legit are looking, they looking for business decisions mm-hmm. most of the time. Yeah. But niggas, like I say, like you told me, hey, look, man, look, why waste time? You know I want to fuck. I know you want some money.
Take this little 150, baby. What we doing? Have you smoked? Shit. Hey, what we doing? Shit. Hey, real shit, man, because it's pointless, bro, because you got to understand, bro, when niggas, like, and let's say this, let's go back to the slam. Yo, bitch, no, she fucking that nigga. Like, what she get? What consequences do the bitches get when they fucking these niggas? Like, you know what I'm saying? But you'll kill a nigga over her. She fucking too.
Hey, cut that bitch off.
This bitch texting in the morning. What's
the post? What's the post?
How you mad at this man? But she and that motherfucker, she pulling up to the nigga's side.
She chose everything. Everything that you, bro.
But niggas be caught up in, man, that bitch ass nigga fucking my bitch. Yo, bitch fucking that nigga. Yo, bitch ass bitch fucking that nigga.
So in that situation, you fucking that nigga bitch, do you feel like you obligated to tell that nigga, hey, man, your bitch just threw me some pussy?
Nah, you don't do no goofy shit like that, nigga. What? You the feds? Well, I ain't telling on myself, no. But
if you gonna but tell if you find out, you, that's your
no,
nigga, though.
No, wait, Joe. Yeah, no, we just thought you talking
if
about
you gonna, if you gonna oh, no, go no, ahead, no. If that's the case, Joe, don't do you don't it. Fuck at all.
Yeah, don't do
that's
it.
The case, you don't fuck. If you gonna run back and tell, what you gonna tell him for? You gonna do that to me, you ain't supposed to do it at all.
Even the situation.
You gotta go back and be like, hey, you know how this cracked up. You know what I'm saying? I knew I wasn't supposed to fuck her.
So I don't do it at all, nigga. But you know you're
spouse. Before you even fuck and you find out she really throwing you the pussy,
you tell your dog if that's your dog.
Do you tell her, hey, man, your bitch trying to fuck me, bro?
Yeah, nigga, you cut it, you nipping it.
But 9 times out of 10, the nigga gonna try to get on you.
I was just about to say, so this is the thing. So you I was just seeing something in the same situation. Nigga say,
get on your way.
He say, man, I'd rather my partner fuck her than tell me.
Yeah.
But he can't lie. He's not gonna lie about fucking her. Like I say, a nigga legit be like, yeah, bro, your gear try to get on me.
That bitch finna switch
and
up.
She gonna switch up. That nigga lying, boom, 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 boom. He was on it with me. I wasn't mm-hmm. gonna none of that shit.
He gonna be warm with you.
Man, look, don't hear that nigga.
So crack. You would rather him fuck her and then tell you.
Because once again, what is it gonna change even if he tell you that? You ain't about to cut that bitch off.
Yeah. And she got influence over you. She gonna tell you and you gonna stop fucking with dude. 9 times out of 10 they gonna stop fucking bitch. Yep. That nigga trying to fuck my bitch on the slide. He trying to see how I'ma react or anything. You know what I'm saying? Nigga, you really Nigga trying to be your dog, trying to keep it a dollar with you. If that's my dog, I want you to tell me she trying to fuck. Because I know, bro, I want you to tell me, bro. Fuck that bitch and then tell me, and then I'm gonna cut her off. I swear to God, because these hoes don't get no consequences, bro. It's nine times out of ten, it's a nigga shooting at a nigga over a bitch with this bitch fucking.
But you got to look at that the same way beforehand. What you got to fuck for?
Cause once again, a nigga ain't.
I'm taking your word regardless.
Yeah, I'm with you. When you fuck, you're taking your word.
So I'm taking your word that you said that you was gonna fuck.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah, damn right. Different niggas, though.
Yeah, once again, nowadays, there's some niggas that's lame that probably lie on this shit, but once again, if I legit tell you, like, yeah, bro, I should fuck sister, you know I'm not lying. Mm-hmm. So once again, I can legit, if I don't tell you that, and a girl come up, well, sister trying to fuck with me, and I can legit tell you the same thing, bro. I think your girl straight on me, like, she straight. Mm-hmm. You can be like, oh, damn, for real? And you say something to her, she can remix that whole thing. Like you said, she
and got then you sitting over there looking at the nigga, looking at her. When you around, like, that nigga looking at her. You know what I'm saying? You in an uncomfortable
position. It depends on the nigga. It depends on the nigga. I know.
It's valid. You know what
I'm saying? I know this nigga not going to play like, you know what I'm saying? You play like certain way, you know how a nigga be playing. But you know when a nigga come, you like, boom, you like that. Oh, he's serious. You know what I'm saying? I know when a nigga serious and when a nigga playing. So, you know what I'm saying? You come on some shit like.
Cause you got, I'm gonna tell
like,
nigga,
you know what I'm saying?
Out,
she can't spin that like
and I don't even want to be around it.
Like, just think about like,
I know, I'm just you know not what I'm gonna saying? Be around it. Now, random ass nigga at the flag league, you know what I'm saying?
And like, that's why different. I'm gonna get to just like,
but just think like, my partner's nigga, fuck nigga your I know, partner. You know what I'm saying? Like, that nigga, he a cornball, you know what I'm saying?
That's
and that should be crazy, bro, because. These niggas be bringing up they hoes out there losing. And I ain't gonna lie, I'm a wasteful nigga, bro. Chick straight told me, nigga, I just like your energy, bro. You straight a grown man. You, I'm like, man, that's just playing ball. I don't even rock like that. Like, that's not me. I'm just competitive. Like, I don't even rock like that. Nah, I ain't doing none of that. And you don't even know that nigga. Man, I done had bitches send me text messages from they niggas like, oh, you fuck with that lame ass nigga. I'm like, damn, bro, I ain't. The fuck I do to you? Man, I done cracked so many bitches like that, man.
Oh,
that shit crazy.
I tell you, like, I tell them niggas last time in the lab, y'all don't understand what y'all doing, that pillow talking with them. Y'all low key spitting game for the real niggas. Man. Like, you legit doing all the work.
Keep
what
advertising. Keep gonna make me drop that list. Like,
drop
that
motherfucker, bro.
We had to drop the list. These
niggas finna go crash out. Niggas got switches now. Don't drop. These niggas finna crash out, boy.
Man, over that
so
drug.
So fuck that cartel, nigga.
Man, that shit be weird, bro. These hoes fucking everybody, bro. And niggas is too, bro. We can't just blame it on the hoes. But these niggas be out here doing goofy shit, bro. Like, if you out here, you out here, bro. Fuck it. It is what it is, man. Like, man, that relationship shit dead.
Yeah.
If you find a motherfucker that half-ass give a fuck about you, and I ain't gonna even say give a fuck about you, that'll help you to help each other, man, that's cool, bro. But that love shit, man, you ain't gonna find that. I'm gonna just keep it a dollar. You not gonna find that shit, bro. Motherfucker out here with their hand, dog. And they think they can stick their ass out on Facebook and get $200 from 20 niggas a week, and it's cool. You know what I'm saying? The real shit. I can pay my bills and live this fake ass lifestyle.
There's niggas out here that actually paying this shit, though.
I ain't fucking with her. And she don't watch the shit anyway. She ain't a supporter, so fuck
her. Well, she should have been supporter.
Hey, look, this girl I know, it's so crazy. Because I swear, last week she was just legit crying about being broke. Like, not even $20 to her name, being broke, right? So my thing as a friend, like, if I was her friend, because when her friend's talking about the shit, if I'm her friend, I'm like, damn, if it's me. Did you talk to her about basically money management? It's like, man, nah, because you don't do that when she, you got to wait till, you know, her energy change or whatever. I'm like, okay. 3 days later, the girl get paid. First thing she do is say, what's up, let's go to the club.
Mm-hmm.
Crazy part, she mad. The day that she broke, she mad. She catch a flat. Mm-hmm. Need a brand new tire. She got a nigga. She mad at her nigga. Like, man, what? I see what's up. The nigga legit got a tire. The crazy part, the day before that, though, she just fucked another nigga.
And this nigga don't got to pay nothing.
Don't have to do shit.
Get the pussy for free. That's what that'll hurt me more than the nigga taking care of you or doing, you know what I'm saying, taking you on trips and shit. That'll hurt me more than the nigga just fucking and just be like, going back to your nigga. Bitch, you ain't getting no money. You ain't getting nothing, man. I'm hurt. My feelings hurt.
That's what
I say. I thought we was off.
Crazy motherfucker say salad. Yeah, that motherfucker.
Like I said, someone just look. Everybody ain't about to be a Joe and end up with the right one. Shit, most of us
Joe,
gonna be on
our
way.
It's been faking since y'all started. Let's see through that bullshit. Joe, come at me, bro. I love you, Joe, nigga. But
listen,
nah.
Listen,
he said he gotta bring out.
The cap couch.
Yeah, yeah. Listen, we family, so man. You can ask anybody in family. You don't hear no bullshit about
you
me and
fake it for all them.
I ain't faking for nobody, bro.
Nigga, I ain't faking for nobody. I get it, bro, but I hope you is. I really do in my heart. I really hope you really not faking, bro.
I'm not.
Because I want to know a nigga shit, that really been through that like that, but nah, I ain't trying to hear that.
Yeah, I don't be on shit.
I got you, bro. No, I'm saying I don't believe it, though. But it's cool.
From your experience, you said that from your experience. Yeah.
I'm talking about everybody, nigga.
You
said that from your
experience.
I'm talking about everybody.
You can't talk about my experience. Love nobody until you go through some pain with a motherfucker, so.
Man, that shit don't work. Once you go through pain
with a motherfucker, that's not the day.
Nigga, it's too much Facebook. Everybody gonna know your pain, and niggas know how to cater to your needs.
Nobody's going
to learn and express their feelings. Bro, this shit is, this a game, bro. You know how many depressed ass bitch, I can't pay my light bill. Man, look, I paid a light bill. What is it? How much is it?
Dude, hello.
$250
Say, man, you look, going through the pain and shit. Yeah, yeah.
They will show you how to get the pussy, bro. Man. They will put it on Facebook, and a nigga going to, quite naturally, a nigga going to jump in that inbox. It's going to be 50 niggas in that inbox. She might get all of them to pay an electric bill. Now, she ran it up, but you get, you know, man, look, I'll come over there. I got you. Crack. Man, gave up $130 for the electric bill. You know what I'm saying? Like, man, this shit, bro, this shit fucked up, bro, for real. It's all access to anybody. You got access to everybody, bitch, nigga. Like, what we doing?
And that's the problem.
What we doing?
Yeah, that's the problem.
And vice versa. These niggas be out in the club throwing money and tricking off. Boy, these niggas be spending so much money on these. Oh, I'm talking about, they fucking regular, like y'all supposed to be rich and balling. Nigga, they fucking regular niggas. And y'all, man, come on, bro. You niggas goofy. You tricking off on this bitch, putting the bed, buying beds and motherfucking houses and shit, man. Man, these niggas coming through that motherfucking when you gone. Because you got 10 bitches. If you got some paper, you got more than one bitch. When you gone, they should call that one nigga.
Only one nigga got to pay, huh?
That's all it takes is one nigga.
The one that love him. Yeah. How long did she say she love
him? Ooh, these hoes so manipulative. I just bid it a job, bro, the other day, nigga. And the bitch was straight like, yeah, I know how to cook and all that. First off, she got on a roll, man. I'm like, bitch, I don't want to hear none of that. Like, I know I cook and I ain't got no man. I'm single. I stay in this house by myself, me and my dog. And I'm like, yeah, that's what's up. What you was trying to get done? We ain't even got to the job yet. you hear me? So how much that's going to be? Shit, I'm going to let you know tomorrow. I'm going to send you. I'm going to send it to you. You know, you ain't finna get me like that. Yeah, I'm a lame nigga, but I ain't that lame. What I look like.
Say, I'm gonna see you
And you finna show me you doing it to me?
That's the price, huh?
I sent that bitch that bill. She talking about some damn, it's right. Straight up.
Bills gotta get paid.
But they only do it because they comfortable doing it. They been doing it. So, nigga, I know I can get away, but let me see if this nigga lame. Now you don't see a lame nigga. Now you like, fuck wrong with him?
He the lame nigga.
Yeah,
though.
Or they want to get over on women. It's just the price for everybody. Mm-hmm. Like, stop it. Oh, I need a man so he can really see if I'm getting yanked out my money. Bitch, look, this for everybody. This what it costs.
My price is my price.
Now after you pay me. Shit.
You see what I'm talking about.
You might get wiped out of bed.
You know what I'm saying? You want to go get something to eat? Straight up.
He said, now that I got mine, I can give it back, I need mine.
I need to touch it first. Let me just hold it a little bit first before I get the man. Look, fuck all. I'm just keeping it real, bro. Niggas come on here and be all that corporate shit. Bro, I keep it real wherever the fuck I'm at, in front of whoever. Like, cause look,
I told you,
we got to keep his own show. I said, cause once again, I know this nigga ain't about to come up here and fake. He was saying shit, he gonna say that off the camera. He gonna say it on the camera. Like he don't care about none of that shit. He know who he is. That nigga gonna say what he wanna say. I'm like, shit, and that's how it's supposed to be. Oh, I tell people all the time. Look, that's why we end up getting liquor. I'm like, man, cause some people might need that type of courage. A lot of people sit up here. Man, I don't know. Like, man, look, fuck that. I tell people, I don't want no fake shit. Everything go in. We don't go over nothing we gonna talk about.
But that's my little cousin just asked me. He say, I say, you know, Juice, he like, yeah. He said your name too. I say, yeah, Mark, the kid.
That's
Mark.
My dog.
Yeah, he say that's a real nigga. That's my dog. He said that.
Like no bullshit.
So then he was like, that's my real little cousin.
But he told me this, I told Baby Boy, I said, man, look, I ain't gonna lie. That's my daughter. No bullshit. I'm talking about, man, look, I'll go sit down behind that nigga. Mm-hmm. That's my straight daughter.
Yeah, he said that.
Straight. All I say, off energy.
He man, said, man, my nigga, smooth. Huh?
Talking about
Daryl Marco? Nah, Marco.
Yeah, he said it though. He said, yeah, that's my nigga. Like, he just, he said, he, what's crazy is a nigga just sent me some shit 30 minutes ago. Today, I told him today, and then he was like, you going on there? What y'all gonna talk about? I said, nigga, I don't be prescriptive shit. Nigga, whatever you gonna talk about, we gonna talk about it when we get there. And he's like, oh, that's what's up. He just sent me some shit. Yeah, that's my nigga. That's a real nigga. I was like, yeah, I know. Nigga, we already chopped it up. Before this, all this, nigga, we chopped it up. I know that real nigga. Like, he was like, yeah, that's my dog. He said same shit you said.
Man, I swear to God.
Yeah, that's my dog, nigga. Like,
Marco, one of them niggas I'm talking about, like you say, how, like you said, your, a connection with you is, if you can pick up that phone, call a motherfucker straight, mm-hmm. whatever. Nigga, gonna sit there, hold that phone, and talk to you.
Yep.
Marco, one of them niggas, I ain't gonna lie, one of the straight deep lowest moments of my life, I remember Marco legit being over there like a Riverview. Mm-hmm. Just pulled up on that nigga straight, sat in the car. Like, man, look, bro, you already know what it is, whatever. Hey, like, real nigga, mm-hmm. come something, talking about nigga, I don't know what time, me and this nigga talking. Man, I'm talking about even before that shit, man, Marco been a hunting ass nigga from day one. I'm talking about straight, remember me and this nigga, that's my dog.
Yeah, that nigga
my straight dog.
I be telling nigga, like, we be having parties and shit at my cousin, I was right next door, cousin mm-hmm. Hop. And nigga, I tell nigga every time, cuz, just pull up. That nigga gotta bring something.
Mm-hmm. Sound about right.
Yeah, I'm like, bro, just pull up, nigga. I got it. Like, we good. Like, we got everything you need, cause I'm bringing.
Already provided.
Hey,
that nigga, he go solid, he shoot that dice and shit.
It, oh man, he be having that 20s at his crib.
I'm here. I'm a nigga had one for his birthday. I'm outside and talking to him. Yeah, we about to get them dice juice. Like, hey, yeah, shoot that. No, I don't fuck around.
And the cousin, he's talking about you. I brought you to one of the parties.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, that's what you talking
about. Had all them
old man, hold on, time out.
Man, different.
Man, look, one day.
You Christians are different.
Man. Oh yeah. Man, look, we gonna turn the camera off. Look, over there one day, I'm next door because my other cousin stay next door. We get over there and shit. So they having a little pool party, bro. And I'm talking about these hoes is busted. Man, I thought they was coming to clean up after the party.
I'm
bro, I'm good. Oh, this guy was so terrible.
Man.
I said, ain't no motherfucking way. Look, if it worked, it worked. Fuck it.
That's hell
hard. Man,
you don't get nothing behind it. It's cool. Fuck it. I ain't gonna say nothing. It's cool. Fuck it. If a nigga can get away with some shit, a lot of these little ugly little monster bitches would be getting cracked. But a nigga don't want a motherfucker to know.
Why do you think they
know?
Yeah.
I'm just saying. Niggas just... I know.
Look, this is the thing. Look, they are like I told you, we did an episode voting for the ass eater type shit. We did an episode when we had people vote like I was like niggas coming care like who ate ass and shit. Everybody voted for one nigga type shit.
Who was the nigga though? I know. You be out here, nigga.
Nigga be on bullshit. Nigga be on bullshit. Where my friend be on bullshit?
He fall for it every week.
Fuck, that nigga literally just said it in the mic and I heard it in the headphone. I heard the shit in the headphone. That's why I'm pushing, bro. This nigga be on bullshit.
Man,
I swear to God.
Bro, hey, no, that's why you
ask.
That's why she
had. I don't do this shit,
bro. That shit. Somebody
happy
every week.
This nigga is dead, man.
This nigga fall for it every week.
That shit dead.
Nah,
we did have a voting.
Nah, my dog
name,
ain't going out like that.
That shit did.
Ain't nobody said your name. You gonna fall for this shit every fucking
week. I just said your reaction. I'm like, man, because I asked, I ain't know what it was.
No, before you even asked, that nigga gonna tell me. I heard his ass.
That was
bro.
Good bit. It wasn't me then.
What?
Shit, I'm sorry.
Damn,
bro.
Damn,
bullshit.
Bro.
No, this
ain't
bad. Hitting,
some
thick gorilla
shit.
Nah, shit,
I don't do that shit, nigga.
Man, look, y'all know what it is, man. This is another episode of Love and Loyalty, the podcast, man. Like, subscribe, follow the shirt.
Please do.
Like I say, y'all, shit, it's your boy Juice O' Something.
It's your boy Mac.
It's your boy Clutch, man.
My dude, like I say, take us off the show. Everyone introduce yourself. Tell people where they can find you.
They don't need to find me. Look, hey, look, you see me traveling.
Promote your business.
I'm working on my own shit. Look, I fuck with y'all, man. Fuck with my people, though. Like, man, it don't take nothing. Y'all sharing these bitches and this TikTok shit, man. Share my people, man. If you really fuck with a nigga, share them, man. Let's get this going, man. $1 million worth of game. Them niggas got a voice, bro, because niggas sure. Like, come on, man. Let's make this shit global, bro, because it's dirt. It's dirt, bro. We just need the people behind us. And if you say you fuck with a nigga or you a real nigga, then do what you got to do, bro. You know what it is?
Actually, I know what it is. Love and Loyalty, the podcast. Fuck with us.
Let's go. It's your new family.
Do you accept?
I do.